Hi, I'm Carlos with LabXchange.
And I'm Mary from Weston High School.
And today we're going to talk about real-world applications for gel electrophoresis.
One way you can use gel electrophoresis is to tell differences in DNA sequence. This can help you tell if you are at risk for a particular genetic disease.
Another application is identification. So to find out the salmon you're actually buying is salmon, or if your ginseng powder is actually ginseng powder.
Let's look more at how this process works to look for those DNA sequence differences.
Specifically with DNA fingerprinting. So if you have two samples, but the samples have the same number of fragments and the same fragment sizes, you can tell they came from the same person.
That banding pattern, though, if it looks different, if there's a different number of fragments or the fragments are different sizes, then you might say these pieces of DNA came from different people.
Gel electrophoresis won't tell you everything. For that, you're gonna have to do some initial analysis first.
Some ways you can analyze DNA include, you can amplify regions of DNA that you're interested in using PCR, or you could use restriction enzymes to cut up the DNA where there are sequence differences.
What gel electrophoresis will actually show you is differences in fragment sizes.
Right. You might have different fragment sizes depending on what DNA you inherited from your parents. You could analyze regions that are non-coding that can have differences, like these variable number of tandem repeats. And depending on which number of repeats you inherited from your parents, your fragments of DNA will be different sizes.
Another thing to keep in mind is that gel electrophoresis can help you find out if you're at risk for a particular genetic disease using restriction enzymes that chop up the DNA with the presence or absence of a particular mutation.
You can also analyze proteins with gel electrophoresis. Proteins, though, come in a variety of shapes and sizes. They can also have different charges and have different pHs. Now, if you want to analyze a protein that has this complex 3D shape, the first thing you have to do is denature it by using heat, and that will straighten it out. Then you have to coat it in negative charge so that it travels in the same direction.
In addition, you'll have to use a different type of gel, a polyacrylamide gel. This gel has a smaller meshwork of pathways to allow protein separation.
And this can help us identify a protein or compare proteins between different samples.
When you're separating proteins from cellular components, you'll need to use a process known as protein purification.
You can check if your protein purification worked by using gel electrophoresis. You can see our sample at the beginning had a whole bunch of different proteins. There are lots of bands there. But after purification, the protein we wanted is much brighter and bolder, and all the other protein bands disappeared or were filtered out.
Next time, we'll explore more on how protein medicines are made.
Thank you for connecting with us here at LabXchange.